ஜெய் ஜவான். ரன்பீர் சிங், எக்ஸ்பர்ட் இன் கவுண்டர் இன்சர்ஜென்சி ஆபரேஷன்ஸ், ஹூ கண்டக்டர் சர்ஜிக்கல் ஸ்ட்ரைக்ஸ் அக்ராஸ் த லைன் ஆஃப் கண்ட்ரோல் அண்ட் இன் த ஜங்கிள்ஸ் ஆஃப் இண்டோ மியான்மர் பார்டர். ரன்பீர் சிங் காட் த நேஷன்ஸ் இமேஜினேஷன் ஆன் 18th September 2016 ஆஃப்டர் பாகிஸ்தான் பேக் டெரரிஸ்ட் அட்டாக் த ஊரி ஆர்மி கேம்ப், கில்லிங் 18 soldiers. As Director General of Military Operations, he addressed the country and reassured the action. He said the Indian Army reserves the right to respond at a time and place of our choosing, and that it has the desired capability to respond to such blatant acts of aggression and violence as deemed appropriate. Then, for 10 days, there was radio silence, and some thought the statement was meant to be a lip service. After 10 days, Singh made an appearance at the Ministry of External Affairs. He broke the news that India had carried out surgical strikes against outposts, killing terrorists across the de facto line of control with Pakistan, overturning the years of strategic restraint policy pursued by New Delhi. In 2015, he was made Director General of Military Operations, one of the top positions in the Army. The Director General of Military Operations, or DGMO, is one of the principal staff officers in the Chief of Army Staff and monitors minute-to-minute counter-insurgency operations and developments on the borders with Pakistan and China and reports to the Vice Chief. In June 2015, Special Forces under his leadership had carried out hot pursuit days after the Naga militants killed 18 soldiers from 6 Dogra regiments in an ambush in Chandel area of Manipur, which culminated in surgical strikes in the jungles of Indo-Myanmar border. Lieutenant General Singh, an alumni of Kapurthala Sainik School, graduated from the National Defence Academy. He was commissioned into 9 Dogra Regiment in 1980 and has held various important command, staff and instructor posts during his career of nearly 4 decades. He is considered to be an expert at counter-insurgency operations, operational art and information operations. Singh, who has served with United Nations missions in Angola and Rwanda, graduated from the Defence Services Staff College at Wellington. He has also studied at Royal College of Defence Studies in the UK and Faculty of Studies at the Army War College of Mau. His family belongs to Ampala Jatan village near Gardiwala in Hoshiarpur district of Punjab, but is now settled in Jalandhar. His uncle, Colonel Manmohan Singh, took care of Singh after his father's death at an early age. After his stint as Lieutenant Director General of Military Operations, Ranbir Singh served as the General Officer Commanding GOC of Mathura Base Strike 1 Corps, one of the 3 assault forces of the Army, which is mandated to cross into Pakistan in a short notice. After serving as the Deputy Chief of Army Staff Information System and Training at the Army Headquarters in New Delhi, he was appointed as the Northern Army Commander. The Northern Command encompasses varied terrain from the icy glaciers of Siachen to the plains of Akhnoor. It got 4 different types of borders: the line of actual control, the actual ground position line with China, the line of control, and also international border with Pakistan. Each one of these boundaries comes with a separate politico-military perspective, which poses a very big leadership challenge. He was mandated by the government to rid the region of the menace of cross-border terrorism and was given a free hand to do so. He used the free hand in full measure to fulfill the mandate. Meticulous planning, synergetic effort, excellent intelligence gathering, and a host of other coordination aspects combined with good leadership played a big role in the conduct of successful operations and a virtual wipeout of terrorism. During his career, he had been awarded the Yudh Seva Medal in 2010 as the Brigadier of 181 Mountain Brigade, the Ati Vishisht Seva Medal twice in 2015 and in 2018 for his service, and the Param Vishisht Seva Medal in 2020. After an illustrious and dedicated service to the nation for nearly 4 decades, he retired on 31st January 2020. Jai Hind.